thank you guys for clicking on the video today on our newly purchased Land Rover Defender. This is going to be the first video in the series, and we're going to be talking about the body design.
The exterior design. We're also going to do some pretty cool comparisons of the Defender up next to what could be considered some of the competition.
Not only the competition, but the past Defenders as well. Next to the Series 1, followed by the first 90, the first 110, even the first 130. We have some footage next to both of those, and we're gonna check it out. Let's get right into it.
This is just one of many videos on the Defender that will be on our channel. We're gonna talk about the interior, some of the tech. We're gonna have the Defender up on our lift, take off the skid plates, and kind of look at the new and improved architecture and design on the underbelly. One thing that's awesome about the Defender is the history it comes from. There's a long legacy that goes all the way back to the Series 1 before it was even called the Defender.
Yeah.
And that's what I really like about the cars, is one that has this huge heritage and this big storyline to follow. The Defender name came in as soon as Land Rover introduced the Discovery to not mix up the different models they were producing. So that's when the Defender name came to play. Prior to that, there was the 90 and the 110, which is significant to the wheelbase, or it describes the wheelbase that the Defender has. So one thing that was really striking to you and I both, seeing this Defender in person, is how big it is.
Yeah, it does surprise you, being the 90, the small Defender, how massive it truly is.
Right, and it doesn't look that way in photos.
No.
So let's take a peek at what it looks like next to some of the, well, let's start with one of the old Land Rovers that the Defender replaced, the LR4. So this is the Defender next to the LR4, and you can see how just massive it looks looking at it front on.
Yeah, the thing's huge. The only thing that I find larger about the LR4, it's like maybe half a foot longer.
Yeah, it could be up to a foot.
However, the Defender is taller by 2 to 3 inches, and it's also wider.
The Defender really falls into this unique category because you have the Wrangler, which from a price comparison, you have to have a top of the line Rubicon to match a starting base price of the Defender. And then you have the like G-Wagon, which you have to have a loaded Defender to meet the base price of the G-Wagon.
And then the Bronco is gonna be the same price point as the Wrangler as well. So there really isn't anything comparison-wise price point.
It's kind of in a league of its own, which is kind of cool. So take a peek at the Defender next to a G-Wagon. Yes, this is a little bit older model, but
it's a 2010, and this is also an AMG G-Wagon. So
a little sport tune suspension going on.
It might be a little bit lower. I don't think it has as much ground clearance.
But you're gonna see something similar here with them side by side. You can see that the G-Wagon kind of looks puny when you put them hood to hood.
Yeah, the Defender's hood sits substantially taller than the G-Wagon.
Just the Defender, it doesn't matter what we're going to put up next to it. It looks like it's walking around with broad shoulders. It just got done with like chest day at the gym, and it's ready to come eat your face.
It is big.
Right. Now, when you look at them back to back, it's kind of the same story, except the G-Wagon has a similar roof line to the Defender.
Yeah, it doesn't look any taller from the rear. They look about the exact same height. However, the tire sits so much taller and it looks like it has so much more ground clearance that it just seems big.
Absolutely. Now, this one really shocked me. This is up next to a Jeep Wrangler Unlimited, meaning the Jeep Wrangler four-door.
Yeah, so the Jeep Wrangler four-door, it's a very well-known vehicle, and it's always been known as being pretty big.
Yeah, and what I like about the Wrangler is it has a similar like heritage to the Land Rover.
Yeah, very, very big heritage. However, it's just American versus Brits.
Right. This the Defender is the British version of the Wrangler, essentially, is how it started. If you
pretty much the same time period as well.
Right. During World War II or one.
I think it was two.
Let's say two, because one wouldn't make any sense.
No, it was pretty old.
Yep.
So here it is next to the four-door Wrangler. And as you can see, just briefly walking around them, I would say the two-door looks both longer, taller, and wider. However, if you start paying really close attention, the four-door Wrangler is a little bit longer, but by sight of eye, it only looks like 2 to 3 inches. Yeah. However, it's more than that.
I think if you look at the numbers, if you do the data, the Wrangler says it's bigger.
Yeah.
However, if you're looking at the overall length, a lot of that length is in the bumpers on the Wrangler, where the bumpers on the Defender are really tucked tight and tucked under. So I think a lot of that length comes from the bumpers on the Wrangler. If you're looking at like body to body, the two-door Defender, the 90, is pretty much the same body size as the Wrangler Unlimited.
So if that puts into perspective for all the people that think the 90 is small, it is about the same size as a four-door Jeep Wrangler.
And what is kind of unique here, looking at the two-door Wrangler now, is how puny it looks.
It is so small. So the one that we're looking at and comparing it to right now is not on average to the normal two-door. This one might have a little suspension stuff done. No matter what, it has a different hood, it has different wheels and tires. So it's a little bit bigger than your average two-door. However, this is still a comparison. This is still a bit taller than the two-door Wrangler. However, it would be dramatically taller than it is in these pictures.
I kind of see a similar length difference in the two-door Wrangler to the Defender 90 with the size difference between the Defender 90 and the Defender 110.
Yeah, it's so big. It's probably a foot and a half more, if not more.
Oh yeah, yeah, it's crazy the difference. And looking at the two side by side, the Defender 110 and the Defender 190, you can really get
190.
The
190, you mean 90?
The 90 and the 110.
Yeah.
You can really get the perspective on that additional, I think it's 17 inches.
Yeah, and as we're looking at this, we can see a cool roof view between the two, and you can just see the difference in that sunroof with the panel behind the sunroof.
For sure.
And how much longer the 110 is than the 90.
And you can even see in the door, the two-door is about, the only door to get in a Defender 90 is about 5 inches longer than the front door of the Defender 110.
We tried to pick it up on video, as you can see, but we're trying to look through the back window. So looking through the back window of the 110, probably 2 to 3 inches behind the seat, you can see the end of the two doors door, and about 4 to 5 inches in front of that, you can see the end of the 110's door.
Yep.
Quick mid-video subscription break. Be sure to smash that subscribe button. And while we are taking this break, let's take this opportunity to check out the original Defenders next to the brand new Defender. So check out these clips looking at the original Series 1 Defender two-door next to the current Defender two-door. It's just very, very cool to see these two next to each other. One of the first times I have seen them next to each other, and it was just, it put a smile on my face seeing these two guys next to each other. Just the innovation and where Land Rover has come as a company. Coming on to the newer version of the Defender, as you can see, the current Defender takes a lot of things from this older Defender. Like the aggressive, I don't know what you would call that, the diamond plating on the hood, the Defender logo on the side, the glass on the side of the roof. It's just so cool how much is taken from the original Defender. What a neat opportunity we have to check this out right now.
Well, it doesn't matter if you're cross-shopping the 90 or the 110, if you're trying to decide if the two or four-door is correct or right for you and your family. It's the exact same vehicle until you get to the doors.
Same width, same height, same design. Yep. You could put this hood on a 110. You could put this bumper on a 110. The only thing you really can't swap is doors. The fenders are the same too.
Yep, the interior is obviously gonna start to be a little different with seats and whatnot because we have a seat that has to allow you to get into the back.
Exactly.
But anyways, let's talk about just the design. This just recently, like last week from this video being made, this Defender won the 2021 World Car Design of the Year.
And it also holds here in the U.S. the Motor Trend SUV of the Year. So this is a pretty big deal right now.
It is. It's a car that's drawing a lot of attention as we're driving down the road. And it also has caught the eye and interest of
We've seen people recording us. We've seen people jump up and down in their seats. And just everybody's staring at it. There's a lot of people that have a lot of interest in this, whether or not that's because it looks kind of like the Bronco that's coming out, or just because nobody knows what it is.
Yeah, and obviously the editors from magazines, the professionals that review cars, they really enjoy it. There's really not any bad comments about the Defender.
No, there's not.
So I really like the fake diamond plating, not only from the aesthetics when you're looking at it from the outside, but it's also something you pick up on when you're in the driver's seat.
Not only that, but it's actually a throwback to the old Defender. So check this out on the old Defender, has the exact same diamond plating, just a cool throwback.
For sure. I also like the kind of very common on the Range Rover and Land Rover lineup.
Defender.
It looks bold. I love it in black. This is an upcharge to get it in black.
Like $500.
Yep. Like everything's an upcharge. We don't have the fancy headlights, but I still like the way these look. The $800 option, I believe, the silver ring here will light up. We just have the quad squares that light up on this one.
I do find it interesting, though, while driving around, this ring has so much reflection that it actually looks like it is lit. So, yeah, just these squares are usually lit up, and those actually become the turn signals as well. But just, yeah, the look of this looks like, it looks like all three of them are on at all times, even without it.
I love the fact that they took subtle hints from the past and brought it into the future. There's a lot of people that are like, I want the old one back. Whatever, I like this. I think they nailed the design. Down here is where your fog lights would be if you did have that option. Again, give me some more money and you can get those. We have cooling on each side going through here. We have a radiator in through here. It's all open. And then we have a little swoosh whoopee-doo that goes around right to the back side of the calipers.
I think you might be a little bit mistaken there. I'm pretty sure the radiators are on the side. I think that is the intercooler for the turbo in the middle based on looking at the tubing.
You very well could be right. The Land Rover product has been after their technology for quite some time, and this is standard on all Defenders. You have your rain sensing wipers, you have your automatic high beams, all up here behind your rear view mirror. It's cool that this is standard, and it's crazy that at a just under $50,000 starting price, you can get all these nutty options that are like upwards of $50,000 in options.
What I also like about some of those options you're talking about at the starting price is just the amount of cameras and how good the cameras are, the 360 surround view. Like, this was options only on $100,000 BMWs, really expensive Audis and stuff like that. And the fact that you can get that stuff at this price point is pretty amazing.
It's cool.
The side of this thing just looks like almost futuristic. Unfortunately, our front windows aren't tinted yet, but can you imagine when all of this is tinted and it's got the white sandwich between it? I mean, that is so cool, like, especially with the black. It's just so cool.
I like it a lot.
So cool.
And it's cool from the factory how you can individualize this. You can get a black roof. You can get it body colored. I do love the side vent here that's functional for some heat extraction.
Yeah.
That's on numerous Land Rover models. It's kind of a trademark deal. The old Range Rover we had the same thing. I love the fact that it says Defender right there. I just love that name, Defender.
I do too. Very cool. Very cool name.
That was one of the main reasons why my wife wanted this as her daily driver was the Defender. And now talking about moving on to the controversial part is the back half of the car that's missing.
I really like it. It's so unique.
We saw this for the first time at the LA Auto Show when it was released to the United States. I think it was 2019.
The one that we saw had the ladder, it had the big box on the side, it had the big roof rack on the top. It just looks beefy, it looks cool.
Yeah.
It looks like it just wants to go up a mountain and stay at the top.
What I like about the design of the Defender is the fact that it can be rugged and off-road, it can look classy, it can look luxurious. It kind of checks all these boxes just depending on the atmosphere it's in. Right now we have a little bit of mud splashed up the side, so it looks pretty tough. Once we get it all cleaned up, it's gonna look classy, like you can take it out on date night.
Yeah, it's really cool how, like, it's not like a Wrangler. You can't take a Wrangler out on a date night.
Right.
You can't take a Wrangler through the city and expect it to look cool reflecting off of the buildings and stuff. And this just has such a futuristic yet still old school off-road design that no other vehicle has. The other thing I really like is we don't have the air suspension. Based on the ones I've seen with the air suspension, they're always at entry level or the lower setting or whatever. And I really like how cool it looks, just big and lifted up with the coils.
Yeah.
It's cool.
So we have that coil suspension, and even looking at the owner's manual and you look at all the dimensions and ride height, the coil suspension at its ride height, which is only the only ride height.
Yeah.
Compared to the air suspension at ride height, the coil does sit just a smidge taller.
And you can see that in this quick comparison on one sitting at the ride height versus the coils.
And moving on to just looking at this a little further, this one that we're next to looking at right now is an $85,000 sticker, almost $86,000.
And the only things that I'm seeing that bring the price up, you could bring to a wrap place or a paint shop and get done for, I don't know, 3-4 grand.
Right. So this is the X model. That is the top trim. There are some differences, obviously, but you really have to look for them. There's so many standard features in the Defender that you really have to start scratching your head and wondering what you're paying that extra $20,000, $30,000, $40,000 for.
The painted bumpers is what I noticed, and like I said, you can bring that down and get that done. It does have the tow hooks in the rear, which you can also do that yourself. The interior is a little bit nicer, but I don't think it's worth the money.
Kind of leather wrapped instead of the funny fabric.
I really like the interior in this. I don't know why it would need to be any different. So I just, based on looking at the two, I don't see the need for that much more money to be spent.
I feel the need to share this because it had me absolutely rolling. My wife has a wonderful way of describing things, and she wanted a 110 eventually, and I was like, get a 90. They look so much cooler. They're sportier. They're going to be more agile to drive.
Yep.
We don't need a 110. We don't need all that extra room. She got into the 90 for the first time. We actually picked it up and she was out of town. So I picked her up from the airport from it. And the first time she drove it, she's like, I kind of feel like I'm driving an 18-wheeler, but without the trailer behind me. You know what I mean? Like when you're driving a semi and you don't have the trailer. And then then the next day, she's like, am I driving a chubby around?
This is the coolest looking part of the Defender.
Absolutely.
In my opinion. One of my favorite parts that's just straight status symbol, or what I think is going to be status symbol after this is out for a while, is the two big black bars. You can see these things from like a mile away. It just has such a road presence with those bars going up and down. And the LED lights,
lights look
so
cool. Let's check it out. We'll get
so
a
good
quick
looking.
Blink there. Yeah. But yeah, it looks so cool. It starts when you look at it from the side and how it's straight down.
Straight down. That's just the classic boxy look.
It's awesome. But yeah, there's just so many little cues that tie it in to make it unique from anything on the road. I love the back end. Obviously, when you look at both the front and the back with the way the bumpers tuck under, you know your approach and departure angles are going to be awesome compared to a lot of the competition.
And if you don't know what they are, you can just look at them in the display, which it says every single angle and whatever dimension that you could think of.
Make sure you subscribe and check out our other Defender videos where we are going to talk about the tech, we're going to talk about the interior, the driving impressions in a future video.
I would also like to say, I'm really glad it's not like the Wrangler. You pull this out, you get the glass that flips up. It's like a G-Wagon. Like, I still think this is like a status symbol thing when you get this massive door opening. It's just, that's so cool.
There's a lot of people that complain that because we're in the United States and the way this opens, that you won't be on the curbside or whatever. But yeah, whatever.
If you park in the city, that is kind of a safety thing. I agree with that.
For sure.
Thank you guys so much for tuning in to the video today on Performance on Wheels, the first video in the Defender series after going and picking it up. Really excited to just dive deep into the tech and just everything on this car that we're going to have videos on, then followed by some adventures in it, going up a mountain, exploring. We got a Defender. We can go anywhere we want.
A lot of ideas coming up. It's going to be fun. We'll have buyer's guide. We're going to have a rundown of reliability, which is the big thing that everyone talks about when you talk about a Land Rover.
Yeah, we got to talk about how much this thing costs to own for sure.
Absolutely. Guys, stay tuned. Hit the subscribe button. We'll see you in the next video.